Science and Technology, Computing Devices, Grade 5. In the last lesson, we learned that we can type and edit text in a document using the keyboard. Today, we shall learn about how to save our document. Our document that you have opened and has not been saved is automatically given a name, such as document 1 or document 2 and so on. For example, this Word document has been opened but has not been saved. So the name is given to it automatically, like this one is document 3, which appears in the title bar. Now, the name appears in the title bar, as I've said. And when you save a document, you give it the name that you desire. So instead of document 1 or 2, you give it the name that you desire to give it. Now, to save a document is to store it for future reference or later use. That is the meaning of saving a document. You store the document for future use, for future reference and later use. A document can be saved in the computing device or in a storage device, like a flash disk. Now, if we store our document in the computing device, in this particular case, we can store it in this computer, either in D, or C, or on the desktop. But you can also save it in a storage device, which is an external storage device, like a flash disk, and this is how the flash disk looks like. This is a flash disk in which you can store our document apart from in the computing device. Now, to save, use this procedure. You go to File, whereas File is here. You go to File, then you click Save or Save As, and then give the document the desired name. And then you specify where to save. For example, we have this document here, document 2. We want to save it. So we go to File. File is here. Click on File. Click Save As or Save. Let's choose Save As. Click here. Then this dialog box opens. So we are supposed to give it a name. Let me give it a name. I call it Sam. Okay. And then after I've given it a name, I'm supposed to specify where to save it. So I can save in my computer here. That is either in C or in D drive, or I can save it somewhere else in the computer. I can save it on the desktop. So I click on desktop, I can save it there. Then after I've chosen where to save, I click on save, which is down here. Click on save here, then it is saved. So if I go back to the desktop, I'll find it there. Or alternatively, I can retrieve that document from where I saved it. To retrieve a document, you go to File, then you click Open, then you navigate to the place where you saved the document. As for my case, I saved on the desktop. So I click there, then I search that document on the desktop, I find it there, some. Then if I want to retrieve it, I can double click on it, or I just click on it and then click here, open. Can I click open, then it's going to open. But I won't do that because already it is open. So I can just cancel. Going back to our presentation. That is how we are able to save a document. But apart from using that procedure, we can use the keyboard shortcut keys. In this case, to save the document using the keyboard shortcut, you click Control and S at the same time. So let's choose this document, document 3. We want to save it. So let us use the keyboard shortcut. You click on Control and S at the same time, like that. You see what happens? That dialog box opens. So you are able to give the name of that document. I can call it Okonji, like that. That's the name I can give it, the name I've desired. And then I can specify where to save it. I can choose desktop. And then I come here and save. So when I do that, it is saved. And to retrieve it, I can go to File, click File, click Open. Then I check on the desktop. Then I scroll. Remember the scroll bar? I scroll like this. And then I can see it is there. It is saved as Okonji. Then I can open. I can double click on it, or I can click on it and then click Open. It will open. So that's how we are able to save a document and even retrieve it. Now finally, let's see how we can create folders and subfolders. A folder and subfolder is a place where we keep our documents. We want our documents to be organized. They were documents. So you can create folders and subfolders so that you can organize our documents. Let me minimize all these windows. Remember the minimize window icon, it is there at the top right, the minus. If you click on it, you minimize. So now you want to create a folder. So I want to create one on the desktop. So I can right click where the cursor is, I can right click. Where the pointer is, I can right click. Then I have those options. I go to new. Then from new, I can choose folder. Then I click on folder. Then it is done what? It is created, it is down here. It is created. The folder is here. It is created down there. Alright, and then I can name that folder. I can give it a name. That's the folder down there. This one here is what I've created. And so I need to give it a name. So I click there and give it a name. I can call it July. So that's how I can name that folder. It is now July. And if I want to create a subfolder, I can double click on it to open it. So it is open. The folder is open. And I can create another folder in that folder. So I can create a subfolder. So I right click in that folder. I go to new. Then I create folder. So this is a new folder. It has been created in the first folder. So it's a subfolder. Now I need to give it a name. I can call it July 2. So that is the name of the subfolder. And I can even open this subfolder by double clicking on it. Now, the document that I created, the Word document, I can save it in this folder, in this subfolder, so that it is saved in the subfolder of this folder July. So if you open this folder July, you'll get this subfolder July 2. And if you double click on this folder to open it, you'll get the document there if you saved it there. So that is how we are able to save a document, how we are able to retrieve a document, and how we are able to create a folder in subfolder in order to organize our Word documents.